To understand how anyone learns, and that what is the meaning of learning? Learning implies gathering information, storing it somehow, transforming it into knowledge. To understand that is actually extremely important for a trainer. And definitely knowing and understanding about the Kolb cycle will have an impact on my future teaching of adults. When adults are pretty set in their ways, so that understanding what kind of approach they take to new situations, to learning, to transforming information into knowledge, to acquiring this kind of skills and competencies is extremely important. It makes a difference if, for instance, a learner is more hands-on oriented and therefore needs to practice, needs to go from practical situations. It's very different to teach someone that like that than it is to teach someone who's a theoretician, who prefers a mind-on approach, who prefers to conceptualize and understand the rules why something happens and only then apply it to reality. So yes, definitely, Kolb cycle. I think it has already influenced my approach to teaching, even though I sometimes would not give it its right name, but being aware of the various phases of this cycle, of the various possibilities it affords, just will make me more attentive to diversifying approaches so as to incorporate every single student, be more attentive to the kind of signs and likes and dislikes that they may show during a class, and tailor the exercises, the activities and the tasks to their needs, to their to create the sort of context that will feel them, that will make them feel comfortable in their learning process. They're very much a part of the learning process, and the Kolb cycle will help me do that. Honey and Mumford developed this model. Again, the eternal question is, how do people learn? How do people, faced with new situations, faced with new information, faced with new knowledge, how do they transform, make it their own? How do they incorporate it into their living? Now, do I know my own life, my own learning style? Actually, I don't. I would have to take a questionnaire to find out. Not knowing does not mean that I do not have some sort of perception of what I prefer. I know that I very much prefer something to be explained to me. I prefer to analyze a situation or to have it explained to me before I actually go into it, before I actually put it into practice. I try not to let that interfere with my teaching, with the training that I give other people. And again, I try to make it the approach to classes and to situations as diversified as possible, so that I do not, for instance, always focus on grammar rules and usage rules, or I don't always give my students or my learners activities that will be very much hands-on, very much practical, without giving them the background and the support that and the scaffolding they may need to then make it their own. So I definitely want to have to take the questionnaire and find my learning style, or at least the predominant one, because I'm very much aware that you don't really have one learning style. One is predominant, but depending on the situation, you will go for a theoretician, so the person who needs to have the theory, the rules, something to hold on to, or the analyst, someone who will look at reality and try to deduce how it works, to analyze, to decompose it into its parts, or someone who's the pragmatist,